Okay, now see, here we will perform a program where we will transfer a block of 10 numbers from one memory location to the another memory location. Okay, so let's take an example to transfer a block. I will increase the font. So it is a transfer a block. Transfer block of 10 numbers from memory to memory location. Okay, from memory to memory location. Okay, now see, for microcontroller there are two types of memories which we can use for this. One is the internal memory or internal data memory, and another one is external memory. Okay, that means the memory which we are interfacing to the microcontroller externally by using ports. So either the data may be available in the internal memory or it may be available in the external memory. And if we want to transfer that contents from one memory location to the another memory location, here what we can do, we can transfer the contents from internal memory to internal memory, or internal memory to external memory, or external memory to internal memory, or external memory to external memory. Okay. So there are different ways, and according to that, the different programs are generated. Okay. So first is, we can transfer the content from internal memory to internal memory. Okay. Second way is writing the program to transfer the contents from internal memory to external memory. Then external memory to internal memory. Internal memory, and last one is external memory to external memory. So there are four different programs which we can write using this type of block transfer programs, where we are concerned with the memories. So either it may be the internal memory or external memory. So according to that, the different programs can be written. So first we will take the simple, that is internal memory to internal memory. Okay. So internal memory to internal memory. Now see, here for this program, here by default, what we need to do, we need to write the simple instruction ORG 0000H to initiate the program. Okay, just I will make it center so that it can be easily accessible. Okay, so after that, what will be the next instruction? Now see, well, transferring the contents from memory location to memory location, what we are seeing, ask here to transfer a block of 10 numbers from memory to memory. Now let's say, or let's assume we have the memory location at 30H, which is the first memory location, and from this memory location we want to transfer the contents to 40H. Okay, so this is the process we need to do. Now here, let's assume at 30H we will take some sort of exam numbers, like is 01. Okay. Then for 31, it will be 02. For 32, 03. For 33, contents are 04. 34, the contents are 05. 35, contents will be 05. Okay. Now, these are few, though we have said here the block of 10 numbers, just we will take the simple, for the sake of simplicity, we will take only these 5, 6 numbers. Okay. Now, from this location, we want to transfer the contents to the memory location 40H. Okay. Then to the 41H. And so on. Okay. So likewise. So here, what we need to do, from this 30H memory location, first what we need to do, we need to take this 01 contents into the accumulator. Okay. So I will write here accumulator here. Okay. So here, what we need to do, first we will take this 01. Okay. So from this 01, we will take it into the accumulator, and by taking it into the accumulator, after that what we will do, we will transfer this content to this 40H memory location. Everyone got it? Then second, again we need to do the same process. Again, take the contents from 0 to 2 into the accumulator, and from accumulator again we will transfer the contents to the 41H. Then again we will take the contents from 32 location, and then again we will transfer it to 42H. So this is the simple process. What we need to do, we need to take the contents from one memory location into the accumulator, and then we will transfer this contents to the another memory location. Right, everyone got it? Hello? I'm not getting any sort of response from you all. Okay, so this is the simple process. So here what we need to do, we need to first initiate the memory location, because we have different types of addressing modes. Okay, one is the immediate addressing mode, register, direct, indirect, and so on. But if we are using, or if we are directly accessing that memory location, we need to write the instruction as move a comma 38, right? That means the contents from 38 will get transferred into the accumulator, and directly we can write move 40H comma A. This is a simple process. Okay, but here what will happen, once we are transferring the first contents 01 into 40H, again we need to increase the memory location for second transfer. Okay, and from the second transfer again, after completion of the second transfer, we need to make the third transfer. So every time we need to point the memory location. Okay. Likewise here, so if I writing by this process, what we need to do, again we need to move the contents into the accumulator from 31H. Then we need to move these contents into 41H. Likewise. Now here by default we have taken a count with 10 numbers. But if suppose the count is infinite, that means we do not know how much numbers are there. And if suppose the count is about 100 numbers, 120 numbers or 200 numbers like this. So in that case, what will happen? Every time we need to initiate that memory location, and we need to transfer the contents to that another memory location. So the program will be too much lengthy, because if we want to make 2200 transfers, we need to write 400 lines. Okay. So in spite of that, what we can do, we can initiate these two memory locations first. This 30H memory location with the pointer, okay, and again the second memory location with the second pointer. So by initiating these two memory locations with two different pointers, easily we can access the data from that memory location to the accumulator, and accumulator to the another memory location. Okay, got it? Everyone understood it? Okay, now we will see how we can write this program. So the first instruction is ORG 0000H. Okay, after that what we need to do, we need to initiate the counter, because here we have 10 numbers. So according to the different numbers, if suppose there are 10 numbers, 20 numbers, 30 numbers, so how many times we need to make the transfer, to initiate or to define it, we need to define one counter. So we will define it with the register R7, hash 0AH. Why 0AH? Because we have 10 numbers, and these two 10 numbers we need to transfer to the another memory location. So the instruction will be move R7 comma hash 0AH, which is nothing but a counter. After that, we need to move the contents into R1 and R2 with 30H and 40H. R2 comma hash 40H. Now see, why I am taking it as 30H and 40H into the R1? Can anybody tell me? Hello all.
I am not getting any response. What happened? Are you waiting or not? अरे जागे आहेत का सगळे? ओके नाउ टेल मी हियर हियर आई एम टेकिंग आर वन विथ 30H एंड आर टू विथ 40H व्हाय आई हैव डन दिस और व्हाट इज द नेसेसिटी कैन एनीबडी टेल एवरीवन इज गेटिंग हंग्री नाउ. Now listen, here I am taking it as 30H and 40H because the two memory locations are 30 and 40. And I want to initiate these two memory location with two path pointers with two registers, R1 and R2. Now keep in mind, for microcontroller, we have only two pointers and which are R0 and R1. So here, we cannot take R2 as a pointer. So here we have only two pointers. One is R1 and another one is R0. So these two pointers only we can use. Aditya, what is your query? Right, Aditya. Here, I think you are asking about the pointers, right? Yes, we have taken it as a pointer because indirectly we can increment the memory location, we can access the data. Okay, so we have two pointers R0 and R1 that we are using here, with one for 30H location, one memory location, and another for 40H memory location. Okay, so we have taken these two pointers with, and for that purpose we have transferred the content 30H and 40H into these two memory registers R0 and R1. Now, what we will do, we will move the contents of first memory location 30H into the accumulator with the simple instruction move A comma. Now here we need to use indirect addressing mode with @. Move A comma @R1. Okay, this is the simple way. So here what will happen? R1 is pointing 30H memory location. So from this 30H memory location, whatever the contents are available, that contents will get transferred into the accumulator. After that, what we need to do? We need to move the contents of accumulator into the another memory location. Okay, so here, how can we transfer it? Simply by moving the contents to the memory location pointed by another memory location. Okay, so here it will be move @R0, K. This is the simple one. So what we have done, we have initiated 30 and 40H memory location. From 30 memory location, the contents are taken into the accumulator, and from accumulator, the contents are transferred into another memory location, which is pointed by R0. Now this is the first transfer. We need to make 10 transfers, right? So here, what we need to do, for this 10 transfers, we have created the counter. So here we will decrement that counter with the instruction DJNZ R7 comma back simple label. Now where this label should be given? Again, the label should be given to such instructions which are repeated, which we want to repeat again and again. Okay. So here, after one transfer, we need to increment the pointer, and these instructions are not available here. Okay. So before decrementing this counter, here we need to increment the memory locations R1 and R0. Okay. After that, we can decrement R7. And after decrementing R7, what we need to do? We need to repeat the process. And the process repeating starts with move A comma @R1. Okay. So here we need to provide the back. Okay. Everyone got it? Now what will happen? After incrementing the pointer, now the new contents or pointer will be 31 and 41. So from this 31 location, the contents are transferred into the accumulator, and from accumulator, it will get transferred to the R0 location or 41 location. And again, the pointer will get incremented and counter will get decremented. Okay, so this will be, it will remain in the loop for how many times? For 10 times, it will be in the loop. And once the R7 is zero, we want to stop the program. Okay, so for stopping the program, simply we need to make the S jump here and then end. Okay, so this is a simple program. Why S jump? To keep the program in the infinite loop at the same line. Okay, and then end. Okay. Everyone got it? Okay, now the same program we will try to write in kill. We will take the same program here, or we'll copy this program. Always keep the habit to give a tab before all the instructions. Okay, now we will save this program with the name block transfer dot ASM, and we will add it into the source group. Okay, so here the file is added. After that, what we need to do? We need to build the program. See here, one error is there, error in syntax error. Move org 0000h. Okay, now there are zero errors. We will debug the program. Okay, now see here, we need to initiate two memory locations. One is 30H and 40H. So in this memory address, here we need to initiate that memory location with 30. Okay, and another memory we will take as 40. Or in the same memory also, you can check the contents. I0x40. I:0x40. Okay. Now here, before transferring, this program, we need to put some data. Okay. So double click on that memory location, put the values. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. So 09 and 0A. Okay. So these 10 numbers we have taken. Now we will execute by using single step execution. See here, R7, A, R7 contents becomes 10 here. After that, next is R1 is initiated with 30. R0 with 40. See here, we are getting this 30 and 40 into R0 and R1. Now the next instruction is move A:@R1. So now here, R1 we are taking as a pointer. Okay. So when we are executing the instruction move A:R1, what will happen? The memory location which is pointed by R1. So from that memory location, the contents are getting transferred into the accumulator. Now let's see. See here, from this R1 location, the contents are 01 that are transferred into the accumulator here. Okay, and that will get transferred into the memory location R0. See here, after this execution of this instruction, here you can see at this R0 location, that means 40H locations, here you will get 01. Okay, see the memory location. Or simply what we'll do, we will check on this memory window. See here, for 40H memory location, the contents are 01 now. Okay. Then after that, we will increment R1, increment R0, decrement R7, and again the process will get repeated here. See here, in this, as we are executing the instructions here, the contents are changing from 1, 2, 3, 4, now 5, 6. You can check in the memory window. Okay, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, after transferring the 10 contents here, the program came out of the loop. Okay, so here, this is successfully, we are transferring the contents, or we have transferred the contents from 30 memory location to the 40 memory location. Okay, got it? Everyone understood it? How the block transfer takes place? Okay, so this is a simple block transfer program. Now see here, in the same program, here we have transferred the contents from 30 memory location to 40 memory location, right? So here, while making this such type of transfer, what happens here, there is no any overlap occurs in between the memory locations. Okay, why? Because the block is of only 10 numbers and we are transferring from 30 to 40 location, that means almost 16 spaces are available in which we are transferring the 10 number block. But if suppose there is a case where the overlap occurs, so overlap will be either in between the upper side or to the lower side. Okay, we will take the example here. I think this paint. Okay, just we will try here only. So let's say here, if suppose we have one block, so let's say this is the block which just leave it. So suppose we have the block starting from 30 to the memory location 40, 39. This is a block of 10 numbers. Here, when we are transferring the contents from 30 to 40, so there is no any overlap, just because here while transferring this, we have space of 16 numbers. So in the same space, if we want to use in such a way that there will be overlapping in the upper side or lower side, so in that case, what we need to do? Okay, let's assume, if suppose you have been asked to transfer the contents from this 30 memory location in 30 to 39, this 10 numbers memory location starting from 34H, 34 to how many times it will be? I think up to 40 maybe. Okay. So this is a block transfer. So here what will happen? From 30 to 39, here when we are transferring the contents by default, 30, if you are using this such simple
instructions, a simple program, from 30th memory location, what are the contents available at this 30 location will come to 34. Okay, so just like this, what we are seeing here, what will happen? So in spite of 40 here, the number is 34. Okay, and here the number is 35 and so on. So in that case, or in this transfer, what will happen? From 30th location, first data is transferred to the 34H. Now initially the contents of 34H are 04. Right. So here the contents available are 04. Now when we are transferring the contents from 30 to 34 first time, here this 04 will get vanished or will get overlapped with 01. So that by default, when we are transferring contents from 34 to forward in the first block, here by default it will come as 1. So whatever the initial count is there or initial data is whatever is available, that data will get vanished. Okay, or that data will get overlapped with the next number. Okay, so here what we need to do, we need to use a process where the count will get start or transfer should get start from the lower end. So what does it mean? Here 35, 34, 35, here we'll take it as 36, then 37, 38, and 39. Okay. So we will take only example of with these 6. So here first what we need to do, we need to transfer the contents from 35 first into the accumulator, and from accumulator that should get transferred into the 39. So that should be the first transfer. Okay. After that, this there should be a second transfer from this 34 into the accumulator. Oh yeah, there is some error in my pointer, so just consider it or understand it. Okay, so from 34, second transfer will be from 34 to the accumulator, and from 34 the count will go to 38. Then the third will be from 33 into the accumulator, and then from this accumulator the contents will get transferred into 37. Okay, so what does it mean? We need to start the transfer from bottom to top. Okay, so that all the contents which are getting overlapped, that will get restored. Okay, so here in this program, what we need to make the changes? By default the counter will be at 0A. That is the first case. When we are initiating the pointer should get initiated at the last number or the last memory location from where the contents are transferred. Okay. So first will be, in spite of 30, it will be 39, and in spite of 40, here the contents will be, we will take it as 42. Okay. Why we are taking this 42? Because here in this query, what happened, from 30 to 35, there is overlapping in between the first block and second block, and we need to show that overlap, right? So if we're having 10 numbers, so from 30 to 39, 10 numbers are available. So another memory location, let's say starting from 35H. So from 35H, we have 10 numbers. That means 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, then 3A, 3B, 3C, 3D, and 3E. Okay, so here it will start from 3E. We will take it as 3E. Okay. So this is the second memory location, so that the overlap will occur here.
And after that, we will transfer the contents, or we will initiate the memory location and we will transfer the contents from one memory location to the another memory location. Okay, but after transferring, here we are incrementing the pointer. So here what we need to do, we need to decrement the pointer. Here we need to decrement the pointer, and then simply we need to do the remaining process as it is. Okay, so here the same changes we will try to do in this program. So here the initiation will be from 39 and another will be from 3E. Then move A comma at the rate R1, move at the rate R0 comma A. So in spite of incrementing, here the instruction will be decrement. The remaining process will be the same. Now see, zero errors, zero warning. We will debug the program. Now in this memory location, again we will put the contents. We will initiate with 30H, then 01 02. Zero 05, 06, 07, 09, and 08. So we have taken these 10 numbers. Okay. Now we will directly execute the instructions. See here, the initiation will start from 3E and 39. Okay, so from 39H, first contents are 0A that is transferred into the accumulator. Okay. Then it has transferred to the 3E memory location. See here, at this memory location, the contents are transferred. Okay, and after that, we will decrement the pointer and decrement the counter. And the process will repeat it. Okay, so directly we will run through the program. Now see here, in this memory location, the contents are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so here 6, 7, 8, 9, these are getting overlapped with 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, by retrieving all the contents as it is. Okay, so it is called as end overlapping. So in the first block, here the overlap takes place at the bottom or at the end of that block. That's why it is called as end overlapping. Similarly, for start overlapping, here the overlap will take place at the upper side. Okay. But here the process will remain same as it is. Only the thing is, we need to initiate the two memory location according in a such a manner that there will be the overlap at the top side or at the top. Okay, everyone got it? Hello. Okay, so this is, I think someone have started the microphone. Hello? Okay, so this is a simple block transfer program. Here we have seen with the transfer with end overlap. Similarly, we can write the program for start overlap program. Okay. And this is only a simple program we have taken for internal memory location to the internal memory location. Similarly, in the same program, if we want to make the internal memory, or if we want to transfer the contents from internal to external memory location and external to internal memory location, what the process will be carried out, that we will see in the next lecture.